have bounty in H2O. Now it's up to the water boards to save a bit of it for next year's drought.
New roads intersect the Abyssinian highlands, and Italian lorries ride smoothly over them to the advanced areas. This is Italy's big achievement in the war so far, and the invaders are going forward like their Roman forefathers, building roads behind them. Wherever you find a Roman road in Britain, think that it was made like this, only with more primitive tools and under less torrid conditions. Blasting and hammering and chiseling and shoveling and wheeling and unloading, Italian labor sweats at its work, preparing the railroad areas for the next forward march. And in Abyssinia, money is the big need. Slaves bear the tribute of the chiefs towards the war, and the big men themselves come to offer their contributions personally to the emperor. Ethiopia gives till it hurts. If only a few hundred thalers or so are carried in each sack, the number of slaves may make the contribution look a bit larger than it actually weighs. Abyssinia's war loan raised in cash.